Welcome back to etherlords 2, I'm your host Lostwolfe, and yesterday, it depends on when you're watching. If you're from the future, this was yesterday, or sometime earlier. If you're watching currently, then this is a week ago. I noticed in editing that there were bits I did not collect, like for example, that. Can I zip past and go and collect? Oh, I totally can. Okay. Very good. That was the one thing. There was a couple of other there we go. This is what I had missed. There's like a little bit over there. I'm gonna go collect that quickly. I think that there's also a little bit of this stuff tucked away somewhere as well. So what do we have? We got a grey ogre. Wow, he's got 40 life. Let's beat him up. We haven't seen this before, so let's have a look at this grey ogre. He has iron skin. There is a chance to negate any melee damage received in combat. That's pretty bad. Which means you have to do indirect damage to him. Let's see if we can punch through a little bit of damage before he gets rolling. Oh, he resisted. Which means that because this doesn't do any damage, it actually doesn't get any bigger. I think we'll start there. And let's see what we get. Attack. Okay, we got one guy getting bigger. And we got one resistance. That's okay. I can live with that. Now, I think what I'm going to do at this point is, I don't think I'm actually going to make treants. And the reason why I'm not going to make treants is because he might have the thing that removes folks from play. We go. Oh, no resistance, good. That's power. Power is good. Let's do that. Let's try and make our snake friends as large as we can before anything bad starts happening on the board. Ow. Resistance. Okay, so what does he have? He has a 6-5. Restless. If this spell has been discarded by an opponent's hero, Gregor is summoned to the battlefield. Their first strike, though, so maybe that's a good thing. Let's do this. And I'm going to keep some mana free. Just in case he can block. Okay. Ah, very good. And he'll probably block, yep. His guys are big enough, though, that he can only make one at a time, which is pretty good. And we'll do this. And perhaps, yeah, we'll do that. We'll leave us with one, and one should be good. I'm gonna pull you back so that I have someone to defend with. Cherry, bye. I like it. Okay. Let's do the hornet. And we won't won't cast this because this will knock. Oh no, it'll be 3. Okay. I thought it was 4. And then we'll do the same again. Keep ourselves a blocker. Just in case something terrible happens. And that should be that. He should be dead. Okay. That went a lot better than I thought it would. And we'll keep you back. Again, just in case something terrible happens. Dead. Hey, evil eye, these are awesome. Flying disenchanted rest to destroy target creature with toughness less or equal to the number of friendly evil eyes, regardless of damage dealt to this creature. These guys are amazing. Yay, okay, so what do we have? We have luck. We have we will almost certainly do that one. It receives one additional spell every fourth turn in combat. That's good because it gives you draws. I'd be inclined to take this. I am going to take this, actually. I am thinking that this is a good draw mechanic to have. And what will happen... So we're going to take concentration. What will happen once we run out of things to select here is it will start giving me the end for these. So I will end up getting learning and resources and so on of the fourth anyway. So I'm okay with that. Let's grab this and this. And I saw, as I say, I was looking at this whole mess in editing. And I think I saw some red I could collect. Although now I don't know where it is. Alas. I just know I was walking down one of the roads and I saw red and I was like, oh, I should go get back and grab that. And now I cannot find it. It's okay. So, we have kind of like a little farm... or a little encampment here. And we have a guy over there. I'm going to ignore you for a minute. I cannot get that without engaging. So let's clear out this little encampment for a minute, in a moment here. Snake. We haven't seen you before. Let's do this. So he has snake's venom. Each time Snake uses a snake under the hero's control bites an enemy hero, there is a chance that the enemy hero will be enchanted by an enemy spell. Actually, we have seen this. Let's get a snake out early and often. Hello. Oh, wow. She's gonna buff out two dudes for no apparent reason. Well, let's do this. And I guess we will attack. What are you doing there, friend? I think you just gave yourself mana. Control this enchantment gets one life for every creature you get. Gone to the graveyard. Oh, and he's going to attack. Okay. Is this a thing that he's going to do? Oh, he is. He totally is. I'm gonna get snake venom. Okay, so this has to happen pretty quickly. Because I'm gonna die very fast if I don't. That's gonna stack if we're not careful. I want to try and keep his snakes as small as I can get them, because that way at least he can't attack. Let's go for making enormous snake dudes. Okay, good. Here's team blocking. Yep. Yep, he is at 28. Oh, he's up more? Really? Huh. Oh, he must have, he does. Okay, that's fine. You're a 4-4. We've got enough ether. We should be good. And now we start winning. One of the great things about setting up a situation like this, with the snakes for example, is that they get continually bigger and your enchantments help that along. And so he's going to get into a position where no matter what he does, as we've seen in a previous battle, he just has to put out guys to defend. And that's great. We should win here, assuming he doesn't fog. There we go. Awesome. And we get another evil eye. Evil eyes are really awesome. I see. Oh, I can't go there, unfortunately. I'm seeing like a little area in there. Maybe that was what I was seeing this year. I don't think so, because I don't think I was out this way. Out quite as far as this anyway. So what I want to do is, I think we should go in here. Cut it, man. Haven't seen you. I was trying to get what you were about. You're probably going to be doing any cutter under the hero's control has a chance not to rest after attack. I don't think we've seen cutters. I want to say we haven't. What shall we do here? Let's start making a guy. And then we'll end. I don't recall how cheap cutters are. I know that there are a couple of very big ones at the top of the stack, and they're pretty frightening. I don't really want to run into those. But for right now, I think we should be okay. There's like a 9-6, and it gets ridiculous. You can feed them and make them enormous. Here's one of the baby ones. This is a 7-4. Disenchant cutter man will not get up. Sacrifice creature to get up cutter man. He, though, doesn't ever rest them, so that is super terrible. That'll do. And that'll do. And we shall attack. I'm just going to go out for raw damage here and hope for the best. Yeah, sure. I ain't going to block. What did he just do to me? Oh, he just took away one of my enchantments, I think. Does he have disenchant? He does. Okay, so we're gonna have to be a little more wary of that. So let's make sure that we always have a guy who can always defend. We will send you in. So we're going to split our forces here. I'm going to make an air force and a ground force. And the ground force will be responsible for blocking, and the air force will be responsible for dealing with these guys. There's no way my snake is going to work out this late juncture. Yeah, that's fine. Let me think now. I'm thinking that I want to be able to do damage back, so let's start by setting that up, and then that's 4 ether. I want at least 3. So let's do this, because this way we get to put guys into play. Yeah, we get to go put guys into play, and that's exactly what we want. He is making himself an army there. One of our enchantments is going to die unless I send... Do these have berserk? No, good. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to sacrifice a guy, because we only have 3, and 3 of my guys need to survive. So there, there, and let's just take you off of here, just so I can do this properly. There, and there. What happened there? Oh, okay. All right. So what I would really like here is... Okay, let's make a dude. And I'll do this. And we need this for you, so that's not good. So again, let's make a snake so that we can block. And slowly but surely what we'll do is we'll get our air force going, and that way we're going to win. What are you doing, friend? Oh, okay. Alright, so we have 6 of them. Let's start just going left to right. I think... See, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to protect my... I'm trying to protect my... Oh, is this guy permanently rested? Is this guy rested and can't get up? I guess he is rested and he can't get up. Oh well, ain't much I can do about that. Let's get you back. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to lose one of my enchantments now. I guess I'm okay with that. Yeah, I'm okay with that. Seven. Let's do this. This is one, two, it'll be four. Yeah, let's do this. And we'll do this. Fortunately, he doesn't have flying. Goodbye. Thank you, friend. That's why I'm glad I had my Air Force. So that worked out well. And we got a Bee Queen. Sure. Bee Queen is cool. I'll take it. Is this doing anything to the air around? No. All your artifacts have been recharged. It's a recharge station. How do I get in there? Oh, I probably go around. More than likely, yeah, there we go. I go around. Let's grab this. Whoa, buddy. I'd buy a round. I mean, I need to hit an iron mechasaurus in the way. Oh, tell me about you. Every time the hero receives damage as a result of the controlled mechasaurus special ability, there is a chance to avoid this damage. So, generally, the way these games work is the trade-off is very often, you know, I will do more damage, but I will take some, I will be cheap and do a lot of damage, but I will take a bunch of damage in return. And so I feel what's going to happen here is he's going to have scary dudes that do a lot of damage very quickly, but they will hurt him, and so he has a chance to negate that damage. Oh, goodness. Okay, so what happens when you get too many cards in your hand is this. It just rolls over to the next card that you can't see. We haven't actually seen that with this particular deck so much. I think we'll do this. And we'll set ourselves up for greatness. Okay, he gave it a debuff. Delusion, enchanted creature swaps power and toughness. All enchantments affecting power now affect enchanted creature's toughness, and vice versa. If enchanted creature is destroyed, return this enchantment to its owner's hand. I don't have a queen. Well, that's okay. That just makes this a little bit more frightening in the long run. I am alright with that. Because we're not likely to drop back down below 7. Oh, yeah, you did that to that too. That's fine. We'll do this as well. And then we will attack. This should be over pretty quickly, assuming he does nothing. Yep. Oh, thank you. We'll do two of these. Because we just need two ether free to make sure that nothing terrible happens. There we go. I am not real surprised. You just fell over like a pushover. And we're gonna be queen. And we got some experience. I'm really just here for the experience, friends. Where's the... It's in here, isn't it? Yeah, there we go. Yum. I kind of hate how you actually have to click on items, you can't just run over them. It's a bit silly. Ooh. Do one. Is there anything happening here? Is this like a recharge station for friendos? Nope. Apparently not.
Another forest barbarian! Let's cut her to pieces!
You're behaving like a mountain barbarian, not a synthet warrior. We're to keep the prisoner safe. We don't need more problems. And this little greenie isn't as simple as she looks. Listen, you mistress of slugs and lady of midges. Take one more step and we kill the prisoner.
Go back to your barbarians and tell them they don't dare poke their noses in here. There's a synthet base here now.
I don't think they're bluffing. I must find another way to get into the camp.
Oh man, and I just wanted their green, their blue stuff. Okay. But I mean, I've already destroyed most of your camp. I'm functionally alright with that, as it turns out, because there's like 3 minutes in this episode left. I just want to grab all the things. Hello. Oh, there's nothing exciting happening there. There's a door here. And there's a thing behind the door too. Oh. I am almost sure that I'm going to forget that that exists. Yeah, I'll take that. Thanks. So it looks like my initial instinct about exploring the map more was spot on. Because we're going to have to look down this way. Oh, I'm gonna learn a new specialization. Prolonged blessing. Tell me about you, prolonged blessing. Prolonged blessing. Each turn, each bless spell cast by the hero has a chance to act one additional turn. Okay, so we're not using blessing, we're just going to go right back to this. I don't like, and this is a problem with games like this, where they make them and then they tie the cards to things like specialization. I'm not real fond of that, because what it then wants to do is it wants to, you know, stick you in a corner and say, oh, use these specific cards and they will get better. And that's not a design I'm specifically crazy about. Okay, so I don't really think there's anything else happening here quite now. Let's go down this way. We've seen this, haven't we? I want to say we have. Yeah, because there's a dead guy over there. Dead dude. So we've been here. I wonder how I'm supposed to get... Well, I'm almost willing to bet that there is a teleporter. That run, no. That run is going to get us into trouble because I think it's going to try and take us back into the camp. Yeah, I think that's literally what it was going to do. Okay, well, I think that's what we'll call it for today. I'm going to have to look around, and so we'll do that tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been episode 15 of my friend etherlords 2. I shall see you all tomorrow where we do some map exploring and see if we can get into this village without having to set off the alarms and all that good stuff. Have a wonderful evening. And good night for now, folks.